So just to recap, in the first video I showed you how to take untabbed solar cells and tab them. Then in the second video I showed you how to put those cells into long strings, add the bus wire, and get it all set up for the case. Now I'm going to show you how to build a case. Now we'll flip it and put the back on. Alright, and for the back we're going to use slightly shorter screws. We'll do 1 inch. These were 1.5 inches. These will be 1 inch. Alright, I got the corners drilled down and screwed in, so now we can really fire through this fast. We'll do two here, and then three and three. Got it all screwed together now. Now I'm going to put the support in for the glass. Alright, so let's measure these down, and then we'll cut them and install them. Alright, now let's measure the other two across. Okay, now we just drill them and nail them in. Leave about 2/8 of an inch here, and then you'll have the 3/8 inch thick dowel and 3/8 inch airspace for the cells. Best way to do that, just use a 3/8 inch dowel like that. By the way, I'm using a 1/16 inch drill bit for this. And then I'm going to use nails like this. Just basic 1 inch wire nails. Again, the best way to leave the right amount of space behind this, just stick a dowel in there temporarily. Alright, let's start adding the sealant now. I'm going to start with the inside. Man, this is beautiful. Perfect line. By the way, these little tubes, first time I ever tried this kind, instead of the caulking gun, that is really easy. That went on perfect. Okay, now I'm going to hook a piece of bus wire from here to here, and here to here, extending out a little bit, and then we'll have the wires go out of the panel right in the middle, at the bottom. Again, the backs of the panels are the positive, so this is the positive. These are the negatives actually coming off the front of the cell. This side. Okay, now comes the really tricky part. I'm going to go ahead and put a drop of silicone caulk on the back of each of these, and then I'm going to attempt to pick up the entire display and drop it into the wooden box. So here we go. Just a little more on this one. I'm going to make sure it's going to stay. And then line them up real quick. Okay, there it is installed. Just take your time and be careful with them. And if you crack one or two, it doesn't really matter that much. The cells still put out power if it's just chips on the edges. Notice how the cells are up in the air just a little bit. That's exactly the way you want it. Almost as if they're floating in the air. That way, as it heats up or cools down, the cell can freely expand and contract so it doesn't break.
Again, the negatives over here, positives over here. Alright, now put the wire through, knot it off, bend it around the bus wire, and we'll solder it. By the way, this is the time to add the blocking diode if you want to add it on the inside. I'm going to go ahead and add the blocking diode on the outside of the panel. I'm only doing that because I want access to it after I seal the glass on. Blocking diode goes like that, by the way, and the positive line.
Real simple to put that in, and by the way, if you can't get one, not a big deal on the smaller panels, but if you can get it, it's good to use.
I use the ones with the alligator clips, and you're good to go. Here's just a quick shot of the solder I used.
I'm going to tie a loose knot at the back as well for these. Alright, here it is on the back. Stapled it down, soldered each end. Again, that's the positive line, so the current will flow this way, out of the panel, but not in. And for weather protection, I'm just going to go ahead and cover this whole thing in silicone caulk.
Alright, now I got to do sew the glass on and bring it outside. Okay, here's a quick test outside. 5.95. You can see the bottom part is just a little shaded, and it's a 6-volt panel, so it's almost there. Here's just a quick shot of it in the afternoon sun. It's getting like 6.72, 6.73. All hooked up at 6 volt, 3.6 amp, 21.6 watts. They're 1.8 watt cells, 3.6 amps each, and half volt standard cells. Again, the idea with this panel is since it's 6 volt, you make 3 of them like this, so 18 volts, and that works perfect for charging the 12 volt batteries. A single panel like this, by the way, would be great for charging like electronics. It's a 6-volt panel, so the 5 and 5.1 volt electronics would charge perfectly off a single panel like this. Alright, since the panel's working perfect, I'm just going to go ahead and seal the glass in now. And then finally, just clean up the glass. By the way, this solar panel can easily run any of these computer case fans. So you could use this for any of those solar thermal collectors I made, for instance. It doesn't matter that the panel's only 6 volts, because those fans, even though they're rated 12 volts, they'll start up and run as little as 6 volts. Just for reference, that one I built is very similar in wattage to the professional. That's the Harbor Freight one on the left. Volts and amps are a little different, though. Mine's a 6-volter, theirs is a 12-volter, but I'm getting just over 3 amps, and theirs is rated at 1 amp. So technically, theirs is 15 watts. Mine, open circuit's about, I think it's 21.6. Original idea was to make 3 of these, and then it would be similar in power output to a 3-panel set from Harbor Freight. The only difference, really, is that with mine, since they're 6 volt, you'd hook them in series. So 3 hooked in series at 6 volt, that'd be 18 volts, which is really what you want for charging a 12-volt system. Great for charging electronic devices, by the way. Those are like 5 and 5.1 volts, so just a little more is perfect, like a 6-volter like that. And it puts out up to 3.5 amps.